The Philippines and Japan further strengthened their defense cooperation by signing the landmark Reciprocal Access Agreement. The deal, similar to the Visiting Forces Agreement with the U.S., would allow troops from the two countries to train and operate together. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr., who witnessed Monday's signing, welcomes the move.
Increases our confidence in the importance that the Japanese government puts on these extremely important agreements that we have. And I'm very glad that we have come to this.
It will also lead to greater interoperability, exchanges of information, and other cooperative activities, both bilaterally and multilaterally.
The Senate needs to ratify the agreement before it takes effect. Senator Amy Marcos, who leads the Committee on Foreign Relations, vows to scrutinize the defense pact. China denouncing the landmark defense deal between the Philippines and Japan. Beijing's foreign ministry says the Asia-Pacific region does not need a military bloc, claiming such groups could stoke a new Cold War. It also calls on Japan to reflect on its history of aggression during the Second World War. China also saying bilateral cooperation should not undermine mutual understanding among countries in Asia-Pacific. China defending the deployment of its monster ship off the Escuadra Shoal in the West Philippine Sea. Beijing claims Sabina or Escuadra Shoal is part of China's Spratly Islands and is not within Manila's exclusive economic zone. It adds Chinese vessels patrolling the area comply with domestic and international laws. China claims almost the entire South China Sea, rejecting a 2016 arbitral ruling that invalidated its expansive claims. The Philippine Coast Guard said Beijing's monster ship has been anchored off Escuadra Shoal since July 3rd to intimidate Manila's BRP, Teresa Magbanua. But the PCG vows to maintain its presence there. Manila's finance chief ready to recommend a ban on offshore gaming operations to President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. Secretary Ralph Recto says he's not in favor of POGO, citing the controversies surrounding the industry. While he acknowledged there are law-abiding and tax-paying POGOs, he admits he's not a fan of gambling. Last month, Recto also said he had no objections and calls to ban POGOs. In 2020, the then-Senate President pro tempore filed a bill seeking to impose a 30% income tax and 5% franchise tax on POGOs. Suspended Bamban Mayor Alice Go looking to snub the Senate hearing on illegal POGOs yet again. Her lawyer, attorney Stephen David, says Go is still traumatized after facing scrutiny during past hearings. But for Senator Rizzo Ontiveros, the mayor should not use this as an excuse to escape accountability. She also repeated her warning that Go's refusal to attend the hearings despite a subpoena will lead to her arrest. Senate is set to resume its hearings into the Bamban mayor and her alleged ties to illegal POGOs Wednesday, July 10th. Meanwhile, the Philippine poll body determined to file an election offense case against the mayor if proven there was material misrepresentation when she ran for office in 2022. A 10 million peso reward on the table for anyone who can help Philippine authorities arrest fugitive televangelist Apollo Quiboloy. A 1 million peso bounty is also being offered for information that could lead to the arrest of five of Quiboloy's co-accused. The Philippine National Police has also released a wanted poster for their pastor. Quiboloy is wanted for human trafficking, child abuse, and contempt of court.
Sa nangyayaring ito, parang tinatapakan ang sistema ng pamahalaan. Parang niyuyurakan eh. Mag-deserve ka ng warrant para ikaw pa masama. Hindi ba? Basta simple lang. Ang batas ay batas. Ang may kasalanan, mananagot. At yan ang gagawin namin, Pastor Quiboloy.
Meanwhile, the Philippine National Police is mulling to file an obstruction of justice complaint against former President Rodrigo Duterte. Duterte previously claimed he knows where Kibuloy is hiding.
Oh, obstruction of justice po yan.
Opo.
And we're checking po if you can file against these people. So just want to make you clear, no? Hindi po siya pasto. He's a fugitive of the law. The law, tatlong buwan na eh.
Opo, opo.
More than 2 months na po nagtatago.
Back in April, arrest warrants were issued by a Davao and a Pasig City court against Kibuloy. The Senate has also ordered his arrest for repeatedly snubbing their inquiry. Kibuloy is also included in the FBI's most wanted list. Philippine Senator Nancy Binay files an ethics complaint against her colleague Alan Peter Cayetano over their heated exchange in a Senate hearing last week. RG Cruz reports.
Ang dami mo nang inimbento sa media kung saan-saan mo nang
inalangin issue.
Lourdes ang pangalan mo, hindi Marites.
For Senator Nancy Binay, these utterances by Senate Committee on Accounts Chair Alan Peter Cayetano during his hearing on the new Senate building project violate Sections 93 and 94, Rule 34 of the Senate Rules on Unparliamentary Acts and Language. Binay also claimed Cayetano committed slander with these words.
But sa akin, for me, yung pinaka-grave is yung pag-accuse niya na nagbibigay ako ng copy dun sa 10 radio interviews ko daw ng set of questions.
Binay also alleged her right as a woman to be protected from violence and abuse was violated.
Kabuang kanaday.
Yung sinabi niya na yung ang pangalan mo Lourdes, hindi Marites. Tapos yung pangalawa nga is yung buang. Magulang ako, so kailangan akong protektahan din yung mga anak ko na ayoko na pag bumalik sila sa school elahan, may magsasabi sa kanila na yung nanay mo pala sira ulo kasi tinawag ni Senator Cayetano na buang.
Binay also complained that Cayetano's actions prevented the resource persons from talking freely. Binay claims that Cayetano failed in his work as committee chairman, violating the Code of Professional Responsibility and Accountability and the rules on conduct unbecoming of a public officer and conduct prejudicial to the best interest of the service, which is why Binay wants the ethics panel to hold Cayetano accountable and penalize him accordingly. But Cayetano thinks Binay is just diverting the issue.
Actually, sinend sa akin yung picture eh. Ito yung picture. Sabi ko, first time ko nakakita siya nag-file pero siya mukhang guilty, di ba?
Wala tayong sinasabing may anomalya. Wala tayong sinasabing may irregularity. Simple lang. 23 billion kasama yung sa lupa masyadong mahal.
Cayetano stands by his utterances.
What did Senator Binay do? She started going around, nagmamamarites, nagkakalat ng kalat ng kung ano-anong chismis, at kasama sa official chismis na kinakalat, is that mali yung numbers namin. She can correct it anytime. Ang ginagawa ni Senator Nancy from the start, nililito tayong lahat eh. Alam niya namang walang mangyayari dyan sa ethics case eh. Pwede ko rin siyang pailan ng ethics case eh. Dahil unethical din yung mga pinanggagawa niya. Hindi ka pwedeng biglang hindi ka member, bigla kang manggugulo doon. Tinawagan ko rin yung NBA eh. Yung fingerprint ni Marites Binay at ni Lourdes Binay, siya din yun eh. Napatunayan lang niya sa pagpa-file niya ng ethics complaint na nagmamarites talaga.
He also explained what he meant when he uttered the vernacular for crazy.
Kaya ko nga nasabing buang na kasi nga parang nagising ako sa mundong ito na sinabi ng DPWH 16 billion malayo sa 23. Nag-sorry sila, ikaw pababawi mo yung sorry kasi 21.7 billion. So parang sa kanya, walang difference ang 23, 21, 16 billion. Eh pera ng bayan niya.
Senate Majority Leader Francis Tolentino chairs the Senate Committee on Ethics and Privileges, which is tasked to handle disciplinary actions against any incumbent senator. The Constitution requires 16 senators or two-thirds of the 24-man Senate to vote to suspend or expel a senator. Suspensions, however, cannot go beyond 60 days. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.
Let's now get an update on the weather from PAGASA forecaster Benny Estradeja. Hi, Benny.
Good morning, Bettina, and all our viewers. As of now, we are not monitoring any tropical cyclone inside or outside the Philippine area of responsibility, and there are no expected weather disturbances in the coming days. However, we may expect the effect of the southwest monsoon or habagat in the coming days, but for now, we have the easterlies affecting the eastern sections of Luzon and Visayas. And those areas that are most affected by the easterlies will be Visayas and Palawan. So expect for today some cloudy skies skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorms over those areas. And possibilities of flash floods or landslides are not ruled out. On the other hand, we have Bicol Region, Quezon, Aurora, Isabel, and Cagayan experiencing partly cloudy to cloudy skies and higher chance of rain showers or thunderstorms from now up until this afternoon, also due to easterlies. And for the rest of the country, including Metro Manila, expect some partly cloudy skies, at times cloudy, with some isolated rain showers or thunderstorms, mostly at noontime up until the afternoon. The range of temperature over Metro Manila for today is from 25 to 33 degrees Celsius, whereas for Baguio City, it's from 18 to 24 degrees Celsius. And that's the latest from Pagasa Weather Forecasting Center. This is Benison Estareja reporting.
Thank you very much for that update, Benison.